I mean, it took me time to understand and grasp it, and to write it and present it in a simple narrative. Present it in a simple narrative, which most of you have missed when understanding your historical details about your media. We never had a strong word in terms of, that is what I'm saying, that when am I talking about imagination? What I have to imagine? What kind of literature behind to imagine? Do we have a sufficient knowledge? Is communication as a concept? We missed communication, even though as a kind of any precondition in any social interaction. Communication, even though it exists as a precondition in any social interaction, rarely it has been theorized and conceptualized. It lacks completely. As a result, it at best it becomes a meta-theory and meta-concept. Meta-theory and meta-concept. We never engage with the question of modernity. We never engage with the question of modernity. The basic premises, you talk about politics, probably engagement with modernity that leads to democracy. Then when you talk about economy, that leads to talks about capitalism. And finally, subsequently, you talk about culture. And so these are the central axes. But in the process, we completely missed how communication can be constitutive of modernity. That is the central idea. We completely lacked, we completely missed, we never tried to theorize. Probably we still struggle whether it should be media studies, communication studies, or journalism. Journalism also never resulted in studies, it only confined to training. So what you study is about journalism training. It's about how to be a journalist. The conscious creation of journalism itself completely delinked from a larger social science questions. Even though it wanted to take, again borrowing the idea of social sciences, like you said that the journalism has to be objective. And that whole idea of objectivity and subjectivity debate is a very much part of social sciences. It's not nothing journalists are saying. So what I'm trying to say is that this is a conscious creation which happened within journalism. At the same time, journalists would like to maintain a distance from a larger discourse in communication studies. And I think in the process we missed, and today we are still struggling when we talk about method, when we talk about what method to use, we have basically borrowed without knowing the implications of these methods. Now, I would like to bring to this idea now, we'll start with, all our understanding is all about American contributions to communication. On the one hand, there is a demise of interdisciplinarity and the rise of the discipline, as some of you have been talking about. I'm saying that the very idea of interdisciplinarity, which started during the Second World War, and along with the end of the war, you find the rise of the discipline. This is where Professor Schramm began the world, gave it to the world in the name of journalism and trying to reach out to communications. Probably today we have reached a time when we realize there is a demise of media itself. There is a demise of media because media today is extremely predictive, and one can predict media. So this is where, are we talking about end of discipline? Are we talking about end of discipline? Or are we talking about that we need to redefine? We need to redefine. And if it's an end of demise of media, well, I think it also gives us potency to talk about that communication probably gives a much wider scope. If communication gives a much wider scope, then the issue and the question arises, how do we look at? Are we trying to look at in terms of new and old? Is there any intellectual purchase to such kind of conceptual binary distinctions? Or we say that, look, we need to talk not in terms of such kind of old and new, rather we need to talk about the very patterns of interactions. Very patterns of interactions, or the interactivity. What happens to interactivity? What kind of interactions are we talking about? Is it a shift in the nature of interactions? Or we talk about still in terms of the way the medium-centric. I think one is the medium-centric analysis, and that is where I'm saying that media ecologists would say that media can change, media can transform society. That is media-centrism. That is media-centrism. I think one needs to critique this axis. One needs to critique this axis by saying that media alone cannot do it. So media alone cannot do it. In fact, most of our communication revolutions, whenever we talked about, they actually gave one side of the story, that communication can transform. In fact, very interesting idea which comes to me when I was engaging with this particular course on media governance. How do we understand when we talk about South Asia, or understand when we say institutions, when we say institutions? I mean, we have, over this last 5-6 decades, we have generated enormous contributions, whether you say a television per se, there are professionals, there are practitioners, there are researchers, there are print, there are memoirs, there are different kinds of things which have gone enormous literature. Today we have received. I think, in spite of these contributions, we find that these are all horizontal expansions, like somebody has done little work on newspaper, somebody has done little work on television, these are all institutional histories. But they do not contribute per se to understand knowledge. That's what I'm trying to say, that even though the kind of lack of conversation amongst these media institutions does not allow us to contribute and understand a larger knowledge of communications, or communications of knowledge. That's what I'm trying to submit by saying that, look, it does not allow in any way, because there is no connections. Suddenly news, suddenly television comes, the arrogance comes of television, they're saying that, look, the news people will tell you, the media, that you are bloody uncouth. You can't always go with a microphone everywhere, jump the wall and ask, what is your opinion? You see, you can't ask and jump and you become a journalist. So journalists feel so that you have to swallow a long way to be a journalist. Because you need to learn how to actually be a journalist. So I'm saying that, look, the idea of inter-medium conflicts has resulted today much more in terms of breathing, contributing to the growth of knowledge of the discipline itself. And that is where we do not connect that, look, this is ultimately we are all concerned about society, understanding society, whether through print or through television or through new media, we are trying to understand an engagement with society. The question arises that in what way we need to reach the reality. I mean, realities are not always visible. Realities are constructed. Realities are manufactured. Realities, the way they are presented, that's what when you say about social construction of reality, you're actually trying to say that realities are constructed. In fact, I mean, there are interesting debates within the filmmakers like Fellini and Antonioni and so many that why to construct reality? Realities are there. Just go and shoot. Somebody would, Fellini would say no. Your realist would say probably no, realities are to be presented. So these are debates. On the one hand, you have a cinema scholarship that also came up. But today, interestingly, you'll be shocked to know that there is no cinema scholarship anymore. Now all cinema, because cinema as a medium has become obsolete, along with convergence. Now cinema emerged as a discipline, it always did not connect with communication. They said, no, we are different, so we are not to be concerned with communication or media studies. We are film scholars, film critique and film scholars. Today film doesn't exist. So the whole identity question comes with the film scholarship itself. But today film is saying that no, we are part of new media. We are part of new media and saying that as a result, there are so many ferment in the field. I remember in 1984-85, There is so much polarizations within communications. If you read one of the leading journal, ICA, International Journal of Communications, and Ferment in the Field, that was a major debate and going back, and also reflections on their practice that happened in 1984-85, and where they're sort of trying to rethink and relook at where the discipline, the trajectories. In fact, interestingly, as some of the classic scholars, those who came from other disciplines were like Hoblin, Legaspar, and so many others, those who came from other disciplines, they went back to the discipline, they realized that you cannot now handle the discipline anymore. Now, discipline completely got out of the hand. In fact, what Derrida also talks about, that modern communications are communications that slightly write on a postcard to whom it may concern. I mean, it's called in the Penny and Post. If you read that book, Penny and Post, Derrida says that it's just you write an address on a postcard to whom it may concern, it keeps on moving in its circuit when it reaches its destination. I think that is where, so we are talking about the Western discourse. So mostly our scholarship is governed by the Western discourse. So we all in the colleges and everywhere. But what happened in the entire process? We got completely deleted in understanding our own society. So the question arises that, like in other disciplines, like in political science and sociology, in other disciplines, at least they try to interrogate and problematize by talking about Indian sociology, Indian political science. Can we talk about Indian communications? I think, can there be an Indian way of engaging with communication? Can there be an Indian way of engaging with communication? And what is that idea of Indianness? What is that idea of an Indian? Who is an Indian? Who is an Indian? What is an idea? Probably the future years to come, when we get into debate more and more in communication studies, we need to be very serious about thinking about who constitutes an Indian. Can there be an Indian way of engaging with communication? And subsequently, even finally, we talk about, if at all we talk about Indian way, what actually we are looking at. I think this is where we were talking about tradition. We are talking about tradition. I would say that we always try to revisit to the traditions. And we know that what this Eric Hobsbawm talks about, that every visit to the tradition is nothing but invention of tradition. Invention of tradition. We may reinvent the tradition itself. I think recently we did some of the interesting work. I don't know whether you can show it as a part of you guys should always see and prescribe to the students. We did as a part of EPG Parsala. It was a major challenge to us because it tried to break away from the niche of textbook, break away from the completely. But I don't think anybody saw. It's all open access. Everybody has access to all these materials and see all these materials, interesting engagement on diverse thematics. And this is all freely available. You people should get into it and read it, EPG Parsala, and where we have a complete, I remember I categorically said that it should be media and communication studies. There are 9 papers so far we have uploaded, and each paper has 40 modules. And each module consists of 3,000 words, text and the media. You can see all of them, it will give you a conceptual clarity rather than being used. It also amounts to the kind of conceptual engagement with thematics, because it's very difficult to imagine 40 themes on a topic. That also needs a lot of time, because when you are asked that how one is different from the other, how do you formulate 40 themes? So you can
Thank you.
that every paper you can see, this is an access you have. That you can see these are papers so far we have done. I was given 10 papers to make, and I think I worked very well. We all night we worked. Each paper you can see, you can have access to all these papers. There's a video. Everything is there and it's tight. You can see we have developed all these. And I don't know whether we'll do more or not, because anyway, so now we're the first one. So the news and society. So you can see everything is there. What I'm saying is that our Dharma, and we are trying to make it as indigenized as possible. As indigenized as possible. Here it is a creative conversation where historians, sociologists, media scholars, political scientists, everybody has been brought together and trying to generate an interest to work on communication and expand beyond, because that is where the engagements are. Now we go to New Zealand Society and we open the audience. And we have audience for the time. In fact, when you go here, I mean, each theme, there are 40 modules. There are 40 modules, and each module will give you completely historical, archival, if it's a news. There must be a lot of engagement with the colonial system itself, news. And accordingly, every theme has 40 modules. Nothing but rehash. So that's why I'm finding that we need to move out
because you are going to be a teacher tomorrow, and you have an imagination to live in this environment for, let's say, 40 years. How do you live without any imagination? That is where I'm saying imagination is very important. Otherwise, it's very difficult to survive in this profession. And you retire with shoes in this profession. Because there is a purpose, there is a passion, there is a commitment to be in this profession. And if you want to have at all, then you need to have the imagination. And that is where imagination is so important. Whether you connect with history, you connect with media policy, or anywhere. And it's a question of where continuously you engage. Now, you find that there are different ways in how media research has come up in India. We deal with it, started with media effects. I think this is a book which documents, I don't know whether you have seen this book, it's called Indian Sociology. This is actually that normally Indian sociology brings out decennial trends. This is my piece on communication research in India that already is a decennial report. And this report is undertaken by the most quoted, most peer-reviewed articles. It's not about any articles. It's a peer-reviewed journal. So that when we make a kind of scientific analysis, in that process we get to know about what are the peer-reviewed journals, how many Indians have published in this journal, and what are the trends that reflect a decennial trend. ICSSR always brings out a decennial report. And in the last 10 years, what are the contributions in the peer-reviewed journals? And this actually is one piece which is on communication research in there. So here, at least ICSSR gives communication a parity in terms of other social sciences, like sociology, anthropology. So now communications also is being given a parity. So we should not miss the bus and move more and more towards what we call media determinism. Rather, we should look at more and more communication.